Soon after Ajax's death, the Trojans woke to a sight they had dreamt of for 10 long years. The beaches of Troy were deserted. Where once stood Agamemnon's tent, stood a wooden statue of a horse.
It is a plea to Athena for forgiveness, to placate the goddess's anger for the theft of the Palladium.
And so the Trojans brought it into the walls, hoping to gain Athena's favor, and to leave the invaders to face her wrath as they fled across the seas. So easily do men believe that which they yearn for. But in the silence of the night, the Greeks returned to the beaches like prowling wolves. And as Troy slept, the statue quivered and opened, spilling from its belly the ruse which would finally end the war.
Odysseus, your plan has worked. Listen how they celebrate.
We'd better hurry to the gate. Our armies will be waiting.
We are moving away from the gates. We must open them immediately. We must hurry, Odysseus. Soon all of Troy will be awake.
Oh!
Find Helen first. Only then are we freed from our oath.
I will tear the flesh from your bones. Thank you.
Stand down.
You will not harm Helen.
Paris, wait.
Do not deserve what I have brought upon them, especially sweet Helen and my father. Please, be merciful upon them.
You dare ask for mercy from us?
No!
My son, my son.
No!
You will die in front of all my men, wiping clean the shame you have brought upon me. Upon Sparta!
Menelaus, enough have died.
All of my sons have perished. My city has perished. I have nothing left to live for. I ask only one act of mercy. Take all of the treasures of Troy, but allow some vestige of this once great race to remain in this land.
Gentle old one.
You think to deny us the spoils of a hard-fought war with pitiful words, ancient one? Your land is ours now by right, and its people shall be wiped from the earth to be forgotten forever. But I will grant you a single mercy. I will make your end a quick death.
Agamemnon, that wasn't necessary.
He is the reason we fought here all these years. The reason why so many princes and men of Greece have died. The world must bear witness to the fall of the House of Priam.
The oath fulfilled, the kings of Greece set sail for home, leaving behind them the blackened ruins of a once glorious city. The gods took pause, not to mourn, not to pity. The gods are not capable of such human weakness. They paused to plot vengeful retribution against all those who dared think they were the architects of history, conquerors of fate, masters of their own. But do not hastily retire, for our story is not yet complete.